This is part 5 of a series on recurrent neural networks. In this video, we will implement LSTM models for time series forecasting. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI text-to-speech. In the previous video, we looked at the structure of many-to-one LSTM. In this video, we will implement it in code. First, let's implement an LSTM cell using Keras custom layer and implement a many-to-one LSTM model to predict time series. Next, let's implement many-to-one and many-to-many LSTM models using Keras LSTM class. Keras LSTM class makes it easy to implement LSTM models. Now, let's create an LSTM cell with Keras custom layer and implement a many-to-one LSTM model. Generate a time series dataset. This is the same as what we used in the simple RNN model. Let's generate two sine curves with different frequencies mixed with Gaussian noise as shown in the figure. Each curve consists of 1,000 data points. This figure shows only the last 100 data points out of 1,000. This data is a 1,000 by 2 matrix. This data has two features, x1 and x2. Each column vector is a sine curve. In this figure, the blue curve is the time series x1, and the orange curve is the time series x2. Our goal is to predict each time series into the future. We use this data to construct a data set for a many-to-one LSTM model. The number of time steps is set to 20, i.e. 20 time periods. The data set looks like this. X-train has a 3D structure like this. And Y-train has a 2D structure like this. This data set is for time series forecasting. Please refer to the first video in this series for how to construct this data set. We are trying to create an LSTM model like this. This model consists of an input layer, a recurrent layer, and an output layer. The number of features is 2. So the number of neurons in the input layer is 2. Since we are going to predict the time series of each feature, we also have 2 target Y. Therefore, the number of neurons in the output layer is also 2. The number of time steps is set to 20, and the number of neurons in the recurrent layer is set to 50. Since the number of time steps is 20, the recurrent layer is repeated 20 times. Now let's write a class for an LSTM cell using Keras' custom layer. The name of this class is MyLSTM. It inherits from Keras' layer. It takes as input the number of neurons. In an LSTM cell, there are 4 matrices W that are multiplied with the current input XT, and 4 matrices R that are multiplied with the previous hidden state H, T-1. And there are also 4 bias matrices. We use Keras' dense layer to generate 4 Ws and 4 biases. And we generate 4 Rs. The biases are included in the W above, so we don't generate them again here. Each W in this dense layer is a 2x50 matrix. Each R in this dense layer is a 50x50 matrix. 2 is the number of features in X that will be entered later. And 50 is the number of hidden neurons. The bias in this dense layer is a 1x50 matrix. These parameters are shared across all time steps. Next, we write a method to compute HT and CT, which will be passed on to the next time step. The inputs are the current data XT and the previous states H, T-1, and C, T-1. We use these formulas to compute the output of each gate as follows, and return HT and CT. Since WF is a dense layer, if you input X here, it will return the dot product of X and W plus B. Since RF is all a dense layer, if you input H here, it will return the dot product of H and R. The dense layer RF has no biases. So this is equivalent to this expression. The outputs of other gates are computed in the same way. Next, we write the call method. This function takes data X as an input. If we unfold this network over 20 time steps, we get the following figure. The outputs of each time step are H and C. H and C are N by 50 matrices, respectively. N is the batch size of the input data X. And 50 is the number of neurons in the recurrent layer. The outputs of the previous step are fed into the next step. They are initialized to zero since there is no previous time step. Now to find H and C for each time step, we repeat the following procedure for a given number of time steps. We use the LSTM cell function written above to get H and C. H and C are the inputs for the next time step. At the end of the iteration, the final H is returned to be passed to the output layer. Since this LSTM has a many-to-one structure, only the final output H is passed to the output layer. The final H contains all the information from the previous time steps. That is, it contains information about the sequence data from the past to the present. Now let's build an LSTM model. Create an input layer. The input layer will receive 3D data. The first dimension is the batch size of the data. The next dimension is 20, which is the number of time steps. And the last dimension is 2, which is the number of features in the input data. Next, we create a recurrent layer using the class we just created above. Initiate the MyLSTM class by entering the number of neurons, then feed X input into the class. This class returns the final H. Finally, we create an output layer. The number of neurons in the output layer is 2. The final output H of the recurrent layer is fed into the output layer. Here we use the linear activation function. This is because this model is for time series forecasting, so it's a regression problem. Create a model for training and compile it. We use the mean squared error loss function and the atom optimizer. And let's check the structure of this model. Fit this model to the training data. The batch size of the data is set to 50. And the number of iterations is set to 50. Let's look at the structure of the model. There is an input layer, a recurrent layer, and an output layer. The recurrent layer has 4 W's, 4 R's, and 4 biases as trainable parameters. Each W is a 2x50 matrix, so it has 100 elements. Each R is a 50x50 matrix, so it has 2500 elements. And each gate has 50 biases. So the recurrent layer contains 1600 parameters, which are 4 times of these elements. This is independent of the number of the time steps, because they are shared across all time steps. The output layer contains 102 parameters in W and B matrices. Therefore, this model contains a total of 1,702 trainable parameters. And visually observe the history of the losses. Next, let's use this model to predict future time series. As we did in a simple RNN model, we predict future values for the next 50 periods. Let's just plot the time series for the last 100 periods of the original data. This has the last 100 data points. Iterate over 50 periods to predict the next 50 time series values. Predict the next value with the last n step data points. If you feed the last n step data points into this model, the output y hat is the predicted value for the next time series. Append the predicted value to the last data array. In the next iteration, the predicted value is input along with the existing data points. If we repeat this 50 times, 50 predicted values will be appended to the last data array. The length of the last data array will be 150. The first 100 are past time series, and the last 50 are predicted future time series. P is the past time series, and F is the future time series. Now let's plot the past and future time series. Plot the past two time series in blue and red. And plot the two predicted future time series in green and orange. Let's check the results. Visually, observe the history of the losses. You can see that the mean squared loss decreases significantly as training progresses. Finally, let's look at the past and predicted future time series. The blue and red are the observed past time series. You can see that each curve has some noise mixed in. The green and orange are the predicted future time series. You can see that two sine curves with different frequencies are predicted. You can also see that the noise has been removed. In this way, we can use LSTM networks to predict time series. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. Next, let's implement this many-to-one LSTM model using Keras LSTM class. Import Keras TM class. We will create a recurrent layer using this class. The rest of the code is all identical to the previous code. Let's check the results. The number of trainable parameters in this model is also 1,702, the same as the previous code. And the past and future time series are like this. The results are similar to the previous code. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. Finally, let's implement a many-to-many LSTM model using Keras LSTM class. Import LSTM and time-distributed classes. Generate a dataset for a many-to-many LSTM model. This data, like the previous code, consists of two sine curves with different frequencies. X-Train has a 3D structure just like the previous code. But this time, Y-Train also has a 3D structure. This is because this is a dataset for a many-to-many model. Please refer to the second video in this series for how to construct this dataset. Now let's build a many-to-many LSTM model like this. As with the many-to-one model, there is an input layer, a recurrent layer, and an output layer. However, unlike the many-to-one model, the output H of each time step is passed to the output layer. First, create an input layer. Then create a recurrent layer using LSTM class. To create a many-to-many model, we need to set the return sequences argument to true. This means that it returns the output H for each time step, which will be passed to the output layer. The dimension of H is n, 20, 50. N is the batch size of input data. 20 is the number of time steps. And 50 is the number of neurons in the hidden layer. And then we use the time distributed class to create the output layer in this way. This means that the output layer is distributed across each time step like this. The rest of the code is the same as the many-to-one code. This model outputs multiple y-hats from all time steps. Therefore, when predicting the next time series value, only the final output is used. Let's check the results. The parameters of this model are also 1702, the same as the many-to-one model. The number of parameters is the same as the previous code. Only the network structure has changed. The past time series and the predicted future time series are as follows. The results are similar to the previous code. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. So far, we have implemented LSTM models that predict time series. In the next video, we will look at two variations of LSTM, peephole LSTM and gated recurrent unit, GRU.